Good morning, and welcome to our Mass from the historic Basilica Cathedral of St. John the Baptist. We pray that you and your loved ones are in good health. Please check our parish website for updates and for links to devotions and other information, as well as how to continue to financially support the parish as we journey through this virus pandemic. Thank you for your continued support. Our presider today is Father Cecil Critch, and our entrance chant is Praise to the Lord the Almighty, number 564 in the Catholic Book of Worship.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
Welcome to our Mass today. Today I'll offer up my Mass for my sister who died yesterday after a long and courageous battle with cancer, and also for one of our parishioners, Terry McCleavy, who is undergoing heavy surgery today. Pray for all of our intentions today. And to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries on this day, we ask the Lord to come into our hearts and to forgive us for the times we have failed to be compassionate, to fail to be merciful and loving to other people. We ask the Lord's forgiveness.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart.
On us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Hear our prayers, O Lord, so that what was promised by the sanctifying power of your word may everywhere be accomplished through the working of the gospel. that all your adopted children may attain what the testimony of truth has foretold. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. At Corinth one night, the Lord said to Paul in a vision, "Do not be afraid, but speak, and do not be silent, for I am with you, and no one will lay a hand on you to harm you, for there are many in this city who are my people." He stayed there a year and 6 months, teaching the word of God among them. But when Gallio was proconsul of Achaia, the Jews made a united attack on Paul and brought him before the tribunal. They said, "This man is persuading people to worship God in ways that are contrary to the law." Just as Paul was about to speak, Gallio said to the Jews, "If it were a matter of crime or serious villainy, I would be justified in accepting the complaint of you Jews. But since it is a matter of questions about words and names and your own law, see to it yourselves. I do not wish to be a judge of these matters." And he dismissed them from the tribunal. Then all of them seized Sosthenes, the official of the synagogue, and beat him in front of the tribunal. But Gallio paid no attention to any of these things. After staying there for a considerable time, Paul said farewell to the believers and sailed for Syria, accompanied by Priscilla and Aquila. At Cenchrea he had his hair cut, for he was under a vow. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial psalm is number 106 in the Catholic Book of Worship.
God goes up with shouts of joy. The Lord goes up with trumpet blast. God goes up with shouts of joy. The Lord goes up with trumpet blast. O people, clap your hands. Cry to God with shouts of joy. For the Lord the Most High we must fear. Great King over all the earth. Shouts of joy, the Lord goes up with trumpet blast. God goes up with shouts of joy, the Lord goes up with trumpet blast. Sing praise to God, sing praise, sing praise to our King, sing praise. God goes up.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. When Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father, he said to the disciples, "Very truly I tell you, you will weep and mourn, but the world will rejoice. You will have pain, but your pain will turn into joy. When the woman is in labor, she has pain, because her hour has come. But when her child is born, she no longer remembers the anguish, because the joy of having brought a human being into the world. So you have pain now, but I will see you again, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy from you. On that day you will ask nothing of me. Very truly I tell you, if you ask anything of the Father in my name, he will give it to you." The Gospel of the Lord. At the beginning of today's first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, the risen Lord says to Paul in the course of his mission in Corinth, a very difficult one, "Do not be afraid to speak out." Many times we hear the Lord speak to the disciples, "Do not be afraid, I am with you." Paul loved the people of Philippi, you remember, the Philippians, who welcomed him, and in Athens, of course, that we've read from Athens, where he had intelligent conversations about Jesus and they got some converts there. But if you read the two letters to the people of Corinth, the letters to the Corinthians, you will get a different story. They were a hard bunch in Corinth. Speaking to Paul, the Lord does not make little of the great opposition Paul will encounter in preaching the gospel in Corinth. The Lord's words to Paul, "Do not allow yourselves to be silenced." Some members of the Jewish community drag Paul to the Roman governor of Corinth on false charges, and the Lord says to Paul, "Do not be afraid, I am with you." So in the Gospel, we continue the farewell discourse to the apostles at the Last Supper, and Jesus talks about the pain, sorrow, and suffering that lies ahead for his disciples. "You will be weeping and wailing, you will be sorrowful, yet I will still be with you. Your hearts will be full of joy, and no one will be able to take that from you." So Jesus compares their suffering to that of a woman in childbirth. The pain and suffering of the mother heralds the joy of looking upon her newborn child for the first time. In a similar way, Jesus is saying the suffering of his disciples is a prelude to the joy of new life. Their sorrow at Jesus' departure will very quickly give way to their joy at his coming back to them as the risen Lord and Savior and through the Holy Spirit. The joy of Easter, the resurrection to new life, is more than just ordinary happiness which passes away. The joy the risen Jesus speaks about lasts forever. In both readings today, the Lord assures us that he will be with us and help us to get through whatever difficult experiences come our way. In these difficult days of virus pandemic, we need to hear that message clearly. We are not our own. The Lord is with us, and he will give us the strength and courage to get through these days. But the Lord will give us a share in his own risen joy because of his sustaining presence to us. May we all have the courage, the gift of courage, to preach the gospel and to be the voice of God in this world. May we be, as Pope Francis says, missionary disciples of Jesus Christ, through the guidance of the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit may bring the joy of the gospel through us to all the people we meet every day. Our prayers of intercession, we ask our Heavenly Father to hear and answer all the prayers we have in our hearts today. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Archbishop Peter, and for all church leaders who guide our church, that they may be always open to the guidance of the Holy Spirit in the decisions they make, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who during this virus pandemic, for all the sick, the fearful, the lonely, the isolated, the heavenly burden, that they know and feel the presence of Jesus Christ among them, we pray to the Lord. For protection and strength to our health care workers who recommit themselves every day to minister to our most vulnerable members in the face of extreme health challenges, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick, for the healing power of the Holy Spirit, upon especially Terry McLeavy today, as she goes through her surgery, we ask the Lord, through the gifts and talents of doctors and nurses, that she will be made well again. We pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, for Brenda Critch, for Cecil and Mary Critch, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers now in the quiet of your hearts today, we'll take a few moments to remember those intentions. God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the graces and blessings you give us every day. We make our prayer in the name of the risen Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of all his holy church.
Let us pray. Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life. The halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Of all holiness, Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Peter our Bishop, with all the clergy and your entire people. Remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Confidence to our Heavenly Father in the words that Jesus taught us.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy
kingdom
come,
thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Peace with you."
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Our communion hymn is Gather Us Together, number 601 in the Catholic Book of Worship.
Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Our prayer to Mary for help and protection during this pandemic. O Mary, you always shine in our path as a sign of salvation and of hope.
We entrust
ourselves to you,
health
of
the
sick.
Who
at the cross took part in
Jesus'
pain,
keeping
your faith
firm.
You, salvation of your people,
know
what we need,
and
we are sure you
will
provide, so that as in
Cana
of Galilee,
we
may
return
to joy and
to
feasting after
this
time
of
trial.
Help
us, Mother
of
divine
love,
to conform to the will of the Father,
and
to
do
as
we
are told
by
Jesus, who has taken
upon
himself our sufferings
and
carried our sorrows
to
lead us through the
cross
to
the
joy
of the
resurrection.
Under
your protection
we
seek
refuge,
Holy Mother
of God.
Do not disdain the entreaties
that
we are in trial,
but
deliver us from every
danger,
O glorious and blessed
Virgin.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless all of us today, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us go now in peace, glorifying the Lord by our own lives.
Thanks be to God.
Have a great day.
Our missioning hymn is Day is Done, number 661 in the Catholic Book of Worship.
No!